Hello students, today we are going to complete the remaining part of the topic, that was Santra cultivation. Let us go to the topic. In this Santra cultivation, we have already studied various parts like botanical name, propagation, pests and others. Now let us go to the remaining part, diseases. In the first disease, that is a foot rot or collar rot, it is a fungal disease. And in this case, dark brown colored spots, lesion, miss spots are seen on the stem. And along with these spots, rotting takes place. And here defoliation also takes place. Defoliation means falling off leaves. And at the trunk, main trunk, scratches are found. Along with this, cracking of bark is also seen. Along with that, exuding of a particular gum is also noticed in this foot rot disease, and yellowing and dying back of limbs are also seen. So this is a very severe disease in this Santra mandarin. Now what is the control? Scraping of affected part of the plant means removing of the plant, or if where a gum is found, that is to be scrapped. And we have to apply Bordax paste on the affected portion of the plant. What is Bordax mixture? This mixture is prepared by using copper sulfate, lime and some quantity of water. So this is the fungal disease. So we have to apply this Bordax mixture. Come to the second disease. It is citrus canker. Now this is a bacterial disease. And in this case, very micro water-soaked lesion appears on the leaves, also on the twigs and fruits. Spots are seen on these different parts, particularly in rainy season. Later on, yellow hole appears everywhere on the plant, on the leaves, and sometimes brown crooking spots also appear on the fruits. Now have a look at this picture. So here these lesions or spots are seen. This is a citrus canker. What is the control measures? We have to use pruning of the affected portion, means the affected parts of the plant should be removed. Then we also have to spray Bordax mixture, as we have studied just now in case of foot rot. The same thing is to be applied. We also have to spray streptomycin sulfate at the rate of 500 ppm, or streptocycline, it is 100 ppm parts per million, plus copper oxychloride. So copper oxychloride is also a part of Bordax mixture. So streptomycin or streptocycline, these are all antibiotics, means they work against the diseases caused due to bacteria. Now third disease, it is called gummosis. Name itself indicates. Gummosis means formation of gum, secretion of gum, or exuding of gum on the plant. This is also a fungal disease. So this gum-like substance oozing through stem and trunk, what is the control measure? We have to scrap the oozing portion where the gum was oozed out, and we have to apply Bordeaux mixture at the scrapped part of the plant. Fourth is Kolsi. So this Kolsi name itself also indicates that black spots appear. So this is sprayed by white fly agent. This white fly sucks sap from the plant, and while doing so, it develops mold on the plant, on the leaves, twigs, or on the entire plant. So the foliage also appears black in color, means on the leaves black color is found. So it is called Kolsi. What is control measure? We have to spray pesticides to control white fly. Like we can also spray this Nivacron or copper fungicide. So these are the diseases: foot rot, citrus canker, Kolsi. These are various diseases in Santra, and these diseases are also noticed in remaining all citrus plants, particularly lemon and Mosambi also. Now come to harvesting. This mandarin orange or Santra, it matures at different times. So we have to first of all understand what is the time of maturity. So generally this mandarin orange starts bearing fruit after 5 to 6 years from tea budding or from that propagation. So for flowering, time required for flowering to harvesting means time from flowering to harvesting, 8 to 9 months are required. How to know that the fruits are matured? That there is a change in color of fruits from dark green to pale green. This is a sign of maturity. Now this plant produces fruits up to 25 to 30 years continuously. What is the yield? Here in this case 800 to 600, 1600 fruits per tree we can get, or 10 tons fruits per plant are also available. Now we have to collect various information from internet. Now there are some important points we have to remember. Now this Bahar treatment we already studied. This is just a recap or revision. Now in this Bahar treatment we have studied that there are different kinds of Bahar: Mriga Bahar and Ambe Bahar. So that Mriga Bahar produces good quality fruits, that we have already studied. So this is all about cultivation of Santra, and examination point of view we should remember the botanical name, the varieties, propagation method, spacing, pests, diseases, harvesting and yield. All these things are to be observed very carefully. So next time we shall see another topic. Till then, goodbye. Thank you.